So you mentioned about cardiac heart attack, and you know there are three terms basically that people get confused of between heart attack, cardiac arrest, and heart failure. Can you just explain to our viewers what
Yeah. See, this heart
are
attack.
these terms?
Okay, sure. See, now this heart attack is because of the blockage of your blood vessel, which is supplying the heart. That, if not treated in time or if there is a massive block, then it can cause cardiac arrest, what we called as cardiac arrest. And heart failure is. It can be a sequelae of your heart attack. See, heart attack, if heart muscle, heart is itself another muscle. So if blood supply to the heart is blocked because of some clot or a plaque or because of a lot of cholesterol on the vessel, so that part of the heart may die because lack of oxygen. So that may not function properly. So then heart will start failing because it will not give blood to different parts of the body equally. And there are another thing which we say heart failure with preserved ejection fraction, meaning the heart becomes stiff. So there are two things, if I have to explain it in a common thing. So if you see a rubber band, if you take a rubber band, if you stretch too much, the elasticity will go. So similarly, if the heart has got a lot of pressure on it, so the elasticity will go. So that's when we call it as heart is failing. Okay, and sometimes that rubber band is so stiff that you can't pull. So that is also heart is failing. I hope people understood. So basically, heart failure is it is not able to meet the demands of the oxygen to the body. It will fall. So means it will reflect in terms of your legs get swollen, your abdomen gets, your tummy gets bloated, things like that. And you will get dyspneic, means you're breathless, you cannot walk. I hope I have answered the question.